These are the tiers you didn't think you know you needed. Quarterback dog tiers. How much dog does your quarterback have in them? I'm going to tell you right now. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to start off here. This joke was just sitting right there for me, so I had to start off with this. Take with this what you will. All right, let's move on. Scrappy do. Quarterbacks that are much more feisty than they are effective. So on this list, this is kind of insensitive now that Kyler Murray got hurt. But I made this before he got hurt. So we got Kyler Murray right over there. We got Tom Brady. He's old. We got Baker Mayfield. He's very feisty, but he's not that good. We got Tua. He's just small as hell. We got Taylor Heineke. I just don't think he's that good. We got Daniel Jones. He's also not that good, but he's dumb feisty. And then we got Mike White in there just because, like, he's kind of cool. I guess the team likes him, so we'll put him in there as Scrappy Doo. These guys right here, we got to ask where the dog go. And by that, I mean these guys were seemingly nice at one point, but this year they're just god-awful. Matt Stafford. That whole team is garbage this year. It makes no sense. Russell Wilson. I don't know what he did. He went to Denver and forgot how to play football. That's crazy. We got Carson Wentz. That speaks for itself. Aaron Rodgers. We can say his team is trash, but he also just doesn't care about football anymore, it looks like. He's just kind of chilling out there. And then Derek Carr. He's pretty up and down. And the Raiders kind of picked it up for a little bit there, but now they're back in the trenches, so we're going to put him here in where the dog go. Next, we have our most crowded tier, wildly average or less. And here we got there's a huge amount of quarterbacks here. We got Andy Dalton. He's less. We got Davis Mills, average. Zach Wilson, he's garbage. Anybody on the Pittsburgh Steelers. Matt Ryan, anybody on the 49ers, except for Brock Purdy. I made this before he got the start. And he's all right, so I guess we'll put that in pending. So yes, all the QBs on the 49ers. We got Jacoby Brissett, wildly average. And we got Marcus Mariota back there. Extremely disappointing. I was going to put him in the where the dog go, but he's just been wildly average or less his entire career. So had to put him here. We got ASPCA, basically dogs that need the best home possible to succeed. And we got Jared Goff here. He's doing all right now, but it's not like he changes anything. He's a lot of weapons. We got Mac Jones. He's good enough. Most Alabama QB should be in here. We got Trevor Lawrence. He's all right, but like, he should be better for what he has and what his skills are allegedly. And then we got Ryan Tannehill. Again, he's all right, but he's not a world changer. But you put him on a good enough team, he'll get you to the playoffs, I guess. Now we reach the quarterbacks I can actually say are pretty good. So here we have underdog. Why I call these guys underdogs is because they played pretty well, but they're still going to have a lot of doubters for whatever reason, even though their play proves that they should be like more respected. So here I put Geno Smith. Granted, I'm one of his haters, but he's been going crazy this year, so I got to put him here. Justin Fields. Again, a little inconsistent play, but the numbers he's putting up is kind of like hard to deny the fact that he should be up here. We got Dak. Dak could be a tier above, but I'm just going to put him here. He was a fourth round pick. He goes crazy. And then Kirk Cousins. Kirk Cousins doesn't get enough respect. He just produces every year, collects his money, and loses in the playoffs. What more can you ask for him? All right, now we got the big boys. We got the dogs. First off, we got Lamar Jackson. Not a running back, not a wide receiver. He's just elite. Debate your grandma. We got Jalen Hurts. I put him here reluctantly, but he's having too great of a year, and he keeps lighting it up. Joe Burrow might be the biggest dog, per se, because he doesn't have anything that's particularly, like, super above, like, average, like, talent-wise or physically. He's just nice. Josh Allen's the exact opposite. He's just so physically, like, crazy, and he actually, like, honed his like accuracy and whatnot, so he might be in the conversation for the top QB. We got Justin Herbert. It's more of the same. He was almost a giant. I wish he was, but he can sling it around. He's been playing this whole season on like a broken rib basically. And then we got Patrick Mahomes, who I think is the best QB in the league. And we saw him at the Super Bowl, like, he was going crazy, even though his team was playing ass 2 years ago. He always performs. Had a crazy first year. So, yeah, I just think he has to be the top. He's too much of an alien. So that's all my QBs ranked. You can look at them right here. If you have any objections, let me know. If I forgot anybody, let me know. Other than that, keep it pushing.